Dear brothers in Islam, Eid al-Adha is one of the greatest days of the year on which the pilgrim fulfills the obligations of Hajj. It is also recommended for the pilgrim to offer a sacrifice on that day with the intention to gain rewards from Allah the Exalted. This act is a regularly practiced sunnah by the Prophet, peace be upon him. Hence the pilgrim and the non-pilgrim can practice this sunnah. This is evidenced in the ayah which means perform the Eid prayer and offer a sacrifice seeking reward from Allah. Also, Imam Muslim narrated from the root of Anas, may Allah reward him, that when the Prophet وسلم, slaughtered two rams with horns, he slaughtered them by hand and said, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. Also, Lady Aisha related that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, purify yourself by offering a sacrifice. And know that every Muslim who offers a slaughter seeking Allah's reward will earn rewards for the blood it sheds, the digested food in its stomach and its womb. Rewards that will be presented in favor of that Muslim on the Day of Judgment. How much are we in need of rewards to be placed in our scales and presented to us on the Day of Judgment? However, to earn these rewards, one has to make a valid slaughter that requires the observation of certain conditions. Among them is to slaughter after the setting in of the time of the Eid prayer by a time enough to pray two rak'ahs and make two short khutbas on the 10th of Dhul Hijjah and before the sunset of the third day of Tashriq, being the 13th day of Dhul Hijjah. It is also invalid, as some people do these days, they slaughter 3 or 4 weeks ahead of Eid al-Adha, then they send the meat in cans for poor people overseas to be distributed on the day of Eid. This is not classified as a valid udhiyah, as the Prophet mentioned. And be aware, my Muslim brothers, that it is not permissible to sell any part of the udhiyah. Moreover, it is not permissible to give the skin or the like to the slaughterer as a fee for slaughtering. Al-Bukhari narrated, the Imam Ali said, the Prophet, peace be upon him, assigned me to oversee the slaughtering of his camels as udhiyah and ordered me to distribute its meat, skin, and saddles to the poor and not to give the slaughterer any piece of it as a fee for slaughtering. Udhiyah is only valid when the animal slaughtered is a camel, cattle, sheep, or goat. Moreover, the slaughtering animal as udhiyah must not have a blind eye or an apparent sickness or an apparent limp. Dear brothers in Islam, know that sacrifice, the udhiyah, is the practice of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. When asked about it, Prophet Muhammad peace upon him said, it is the practice of your father Ibrahim. It was mentioned in the Holy Quran that Allah revealed to Prophet Ibrahim through a dream to slaughter his son Ismail. Prophet Ibrahim knew that this was an order from Allah, as the dreams of the prophets are revelations from Allah. So, full of determination, he set forth to fulfill the order of his Lord. Prophet Ibrahim tried to slaughter his son, but the knife did not cut the throat of Ismail because Allah did not will for that incident of slaughtering to occur. Allah is the creator of all existing things and the one who controls all the creations. There is no creator except Allah. Verily, neither the knife creates the cutting, nor does the human being by his movement. Ayah 2 of Surah Al-Furqan, it means Allah created everything. Allah, by his eternal knowledge, which does not increase, decrease, or renew, the sincerity and the total obedience of both the Father and the Son. At this point, an angel told Prophet Ibrahim, O Ibrahim, you have fulfilled the order of Allah. Take this sacrifice instead of your son. Ibrahim looked up and saw Angel Jibreel descending with a great ram to be slaughtered instead of his son Ismail. On this great occasion of Eid, it is important that you do the following. Visit your relatives, give charity to the poor and the orphans, and be especially kind to widows and those who are unhappy. Visit the cemetery to recite verses of Quran for deceased Muslims and pray to Allah for them. When you see your Muslim brothers, say to them, may Allah accept your good deeds. So I say to you, may Allah accept your good deeds. And I ask Allah to grant us and yourselves a blessed day of Eid, and Allah knows best. وكل عام وأنتم بخير.